part 3 of our Fermentation Device Smackdown series. We look at and rate each device's performance at 3 different stages during a 30-day fermentation period. Let's dive in. Day 6 of our device Smackdown, and this is where we've been storing it. Well, let's take a look inside. Old school method. Look at that, a little bit of foam has formed. None of the other devices have that. That's very natural for the open method. So I'm just gonna wipe it out, wipe it off the jar. If there's any little bit I can reach here in the container, wipe that out too. Still smells wonderful. Probably want to add a little more water to that kraut source seal. This is just barely pressing down on the vegetables. Like maybe what I'll do is I'll twist it, set it down, and then use the ring to create additional pressure. Here are the scores at the end of day 6. Mason Tops has jumped to an early lead. The overall average scores will be updated after all 3 check-ins have been completed. Looking at it today, wonderful aroma, looks great. It's a little dry, so I'm going to top it off with just a little bit of brine. And put the jar. Smells wonderful. Brine level looks also a little bit, has evaporated, which is normal over the course of a long fermentation like what we're doing. No visible signs of mold. Looks great, no visible signs of mold. No visible signs of mold. Aroma is great. Also going to top it off with a little brine. Smells great. No visible signs of mold. And I topped this off with just a little bit, about 2 tablespoons of brine, because it was looking a little bit dry. But otherwise looks great. Here is our kraut source device. And it actually looks like it's dried out a little bit. And I can tell because the little water that's been in the little moat has completely evaporated. So think that's what happened. So let's remove. Yeah, you can see there's some slight discoloration in the top contents. Nothing really to worry about, but it does have a little bit of a funky smell. So I'm going to remove the top layer here. I'm going to add another couple of homemade, these are clay weights that were made by some folks up in Washington State. So I'm going to add a couple of those. And I'm doing this because the kraut source lid here isn't quite getting all the way down to the brine. I topped it off with a little bit of brine, and I refilled the moat, which had become pretty much dry, our three-piece homemade airlock. Smells lovely. Brine level is nice. No visible mold. And the airlock has plenty of water in it. Good to go. At the end of day 18, the three-piece airlock jumped slightly ahead. It was the only device which didn't need any topping off of brine. Once again, the overall average scores will be updated after the third and final check-in has been completed. It's the 30th and final day of our fermentation device smackdown. Let's take a look. For the most part, things look and smell really great. Let's see how the old school method has fared. Looks really good. No signs of foam or mold. Good amount of brine. Pleasant aroma. No funky aromas. No signs of mold. And a really decent brine level. All right, mason tops. Nice aroma, good level of brine, no signs of visible mold, it's looking great. After that we have the Sterilock lid, wonderful aroma. I don't see any mold, except a little bit of dryness, but nothing to even really scrape or clean out. Next we'll look at fermentin. If I remove the top part of the cap, I can see there's still plenty of water in the little airlock. I don't see any mold. It smells wonderful. I'm going to remove the ceramic weight. Great brine level. Here is kraut source. You can see there's a little bit of water left in the moat. Can remove that part. Unscrew the ring. I'm going to unlock the spring. Remove that. Pull this out. Oh, and I do see a little bit of mold here, as you can kind of see. There's a little bit of mold that's formed in the little ring. Brine level is still good. If you remove the ring, you can kind of see it's like a little bubble of mold. Nothing to be alarmed about. But we do want to clean that up. You can kind of see there's one little bubble. Little bubble of yeast there. Just gonna pop the bubble. Do my best to wipe that out. It smells, it's a little bit off, but again, this is not something I would ever throw out. I might remove a little bit of the top layer there. So maybe one or two pieces, but remember that it's fine under the brine. We have our homemade three-piece airlock system. There's still plenty of water in the airlock. Looks like there's a good amount of brine. It's a little bit of discoloration on the top surface. A little bit of sauerkraut juice that made its way into the airlock. Interesting. So yeah, what I'll probably do is just take out the topmost layer here. Looks and smells fine now. Well, that concludes the performance part of our smackdown. There are just a few other criteria that we're going to measure and make our final ratings for. Let's go inside. At the end of the first two phases, we have a tight race. Mason Tops is in the lead, neck and neck with Fermentacap. Sterilock and Fermentin are hot on their heels, with the rest of the pack not far behind. And we still have one more lap to go. In part four, we will look at the post-fermentation criteria, come up with our final average score, and declare a winner. Check it out on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/fermentersclub.